And welcome back to Ultimate Arm.
So today is the final day of the build. So this rifle started out as the Savage 110 Tactical with the 24-inch heavy fluted barrel and then the MDT XRS chassis system. So we got her finally put together and I think she looks pretty good so far. So let's find out what the final build cost was and in the end, is it worth doing it or not? So the rifle itself was a standard factory Savage 110 Tactical in 6.5 Creedmoor with the heavy fluted barrel with a threaded muzzle brake on. So that rifle by itself with the mag that it came with was $1,000 Canadian plus the tax. So then we stripped the stock off of it and we put on the MDT XRS chassis system, which actually looks pretty good. This one's in coyote tan and this cost me, $762 and change. That was Canadian and that was tax included. So that wasn't too bad. So then we went with a set of MDT Premier medium high rings. These are 34 millimeter rings and the rings cost me about $150 Canadian and that was plus tax. On top of that, we went with the Athlon Cronus 4.5 by 29 by 56 first focal plane MOA scope. So the scope cost me $2,500 Canadian and that was all in. Then we went with the MDT GrnPod. This is an Arca rail one. I like the GrnPods. I like the fact I can change the feet on them, put Atlas bike feet on them if I want. So the bipod was $239 Canadian plus the tax. I went with a Magpul Arca rail. I couldn't find one that really fit onto the rifle that well. I found this one at one of the stores that's near me, one of the gun shops. So I picked it up. It was $50 Canadian. It mounted okay. There's no issues with it at all. And it comes with little screw-in pegs, so when you're sliding your bipod back and forth, you don't slide it all the way to the end and it falls off on you. After that, we went with, originally, I went with an MDT Elite muzzle brake. And this is what it looks like right here. Now, they're about $150. There's nothing wrong with these brakes. So I tried it out on the gun. It works, but aesthetically wise, doesn't match the gun. So I went with Spearhead Machine muzzle brake. This is one of their new muzzle brakes that I have on the gun. I don't know if you can see it very well. I'll post a picture of it up afterwards during the video. This is a 4-port brake with 3 ports on the top. This is a self-timing brake. It looks similar to like a Sidewinder or a Heathen brake made by Inside Arms, but they don't have the ports on the top. And what's really slick is they send you a tool for it that fits into one of the ports on the top so you can time it yourself without using wrenches or anything like that. And you can actually level it because of that. Now, they do come in specific sizes, which is really nice. So they'll come in like a 30 cal, 7 mil. They'll come in 6.5 Creedmoor. You can get them in 223, 6 mil. And you can get them in like a 5/8 by 24 thread and I believe a 3/4 by 24 thread. I'll leave a link in the description for you guys to take a look at them. Let me know what you think. They come in solid stainless steel finish and they come in black nitrate finish. So I have this one in black nitrate finish. I also got one of their barrel tuners. So this is a Spearhead barrel tuner, as you can see right here. This is incredible. So instead of playing around with seating depth, you do a load test, you find one that works, groups well, put this on in behind your muzzle brake, screw it in, give it a quick lock, and start tuning it. You'll find your grouping start changing. And you just keep turning it and clamping it down until you find the perfect balance, basically, and harmonics with the bullet that you're using. So once I get the load test done, I do have one load test already done. This was a 100-yard load test with 140 grain bowtail hollow points. As you can see, I just zeroed the gun in. I started working my load across. This load right down here and this load right over here are the two most promising loads. But I'm really not going to be staying with 140 grain bowtails. I prefer to use 147s, they got better BC. So this is what the gun looks like. So this gun in total cost me $5,195 Canadian plus the tax. So I'm pushing about $5,700 on the gun, but that's with the scope. I know this gun was a good shooter before, but I wanted something that was more like a PRS rifle and a precision rifle instead of just like a normal hunting rifle that I could take to the range with. So hence why I created it. Plus I wanted to give my RPR a bit of a break. It is heavy. It's not something you want to be lugging around on a PRS match with all day long. It's just too heavy. So this guy is going to be my new PRS rifle. The only other thing I have coming, I don't have them in yet, I'm waiting for MDT to send them to me, is a couple weights to balance it with. But I'm not sure if I'm going to need them once I get this barrel tuner on. So we'll have to see. The last thing we got, well, I didn't get, I already had them. I had Magpul pmags. I have 5-round mags. I've been using these on my RPR. They work. They're like $40 a mag. I'll stick with my pmags. They fit incredibly well. Barely any movement on them. The gun cycles really well with it. You know, I am not going to change mags out just because I think I need the mags. I don't need the mags. Do I think this gun is a good shooter? I believe it is. Do I think it will be a better shooter now? I definitely do think it'll be a better shooter. But time will tell on how it does with the 147 grains. I wasn't getting deep into a rifle. I figured if I can take a rifle that I know was a good shooter to begin with and make it better, and it doesn't cost me an arm and a leg, I'm sticking with it. That's my theory. That's how I'm doing it. If it works for me, it works. So there you go, guys. There's my final video, other than the shooting video, of the build that I've been working on with the Savage 110 Tactical 6.5 Creedmoor and the XRS chassis. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. If you like the channel so far, please subscribe. Yeah, and we'll see you at the range next with the last and final video for this one. And we'll see you next time at Ultimate Creedmoor Shooting. Bye for now.